Hey there, I'm Steve and you're watching Car Simplified. Today I've got kind of an embarrassing repair because I forgot to take my key out of my pocket when I did the laundry and it went through the laundry. It is damaged now and today's video is going to be repairing it. I've got an assortment of things laid out for the repair today. I've got a soldering iron, I've got a pick, which will help in multiple ways, some solder, an air mask. I'll also use some electronic parts cleaner if I have to, but I'll do that outside. I'll bring the camera in close so you can get a good look at this repair. While that soldering iron is heating up, I'll open up this key. Actually, this thing comes apart before I even unscrew it, so I'll just do that first. There's that. There's the chip. There's a pin. Here's the piece that I need to repair. That is normally attached right here. Looks like I'm using one of these. Now I tested this board out already. The buttons do work. I know that everything works. It looks like there's not anything I have to scrape off of here, so I'm just gonna go right to the solder. I'm just gonna do resin core solder. There we go. Oh man, I hope I centered that right. It looks like it's off. Yeah, that's way off. And I'm gonna clean that off. Alright, try to aim it straight this time. One thing I always take care to do is not apply heat longer than I have to. The heat will work its way down the circuit and it can burn out components on the board. And then you have to replace the whole thing, so you really don't want that. Let's see how this ended up. That looks pretty good.
Turn off the soldering gun because I think I'm done here. Slide this pin back in, finish tightening these screws. All right, it looks good, but let's see if it actually works.
Nice. Alright, so I was able to get this key working again, and I got lucky with this. It wasn't filled with goop or grease and grime inside. Had it been though, I could use some electrical contact cleaner to clean out anything on the chip inside here. Make sure that if you're using a soldering iron or contact cleaner, that you have good ventilation and you can get those fumes out of your way so you're not breathing them in. Just know that not every key is savable. If the chip inside is broken, there's no way that I know of at least to repair those things. All the stuff that I used in this video and some of the stuff that I didn't will be linked to in the description below. Make sure you check that out. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next video.